A very good afternoon to our respected sir and my team member. Today, I, Oshi Mazumdar and Ohira Shah is going to deliver a PowerPoint presentation on the topic Code Generation and Optimization, which falls under the subject Compiler Design. Today's date is 3rd January 2021. The first part of the PowerPoint will be explained by me, that is Oshi, and the second part, that is the questionnaire part, will be explained by my team member Ohira Shah. So let's begin from the beginning. So as we know that the subject is compiler design, so I would like to explain what is compiler. A compiler is basically a program. A compiler is a program which converts or which translates high-level language to low-level language. A compiler implements a formal transformation from high-level source program to low-level target program. Compiler design can define an end-to-end solution or tackle a defined subset that interfaces with the other compilation tools, example, preprocessors, assemblers, linkers. There's a diagram in the PowerPoint which you all can see, that is the compiler is translating high level language, that is any language like Java, Python, C, C++ to the low level language, that is machine code. Now I would like to explain the functionalities of a compiler. The first functionality mentioned here is generate correct code. The second is manage storage of all variables and code. The third is recognize legal programs. And the fourth is agree on the format for object code. So basically the compiler not only translates a language, a high level language to the low level language, but it also checks whether there is any error present in it. It can be syntax error or semantic errors too. Now I would like to go to the next slide, which is types of compiler. So basically, we can see there are three types of compilers mentioned here, that is native code compiler, cross compiler, source to source compiler or trans compiler. The first one, native compiler. A native compiler is a compiler that works on a compilation for the same technology on which it runs. It uses the same operating system or platform as the software for which it is assembling machine level language. Now the second compiler, that is cross compiler. A cross compiler is a compiler capable of creating executable code for a platform other than the one on which the compiler is running. Example, a compiler that runs on a Windows 7 PC but generates code that runs on Android smartphone is a cross compiler. Now the third one, source to source compiler or S2S compiler or trans compiler. It is a compiler or is a type of translator that takes the source code of a program written in a programming language as its input and produces an equivalent source code in the same or different programming language. A source-to-source translator converts between programming languages that operate at approximately the same level of abstraction, while a traditional compiler translates from a higher level programming language to a lower level programming language. For example, a source-to-source compiler may perform a translation of a program from Python to JavaScript, while a traditional compiler translates from a language like C to assembler or Java to bytecode. An automatic parallelizing compiler will frequently take in high-level language program as an input and then transform the code and annotate it with code annotations. Example, OpenMP or language constructs, which can be explained by Fortran's for all statements. Another purpose of source-to-source compiling is translating legacy code to use the next version of the underlying programming language or an API that breaks backward compatibility. It will perform automatic code refactoring, which is useful when the programs to refactor or outside to the control of the original implementer. For example, converting programs from Python 2 to Python 3 or converting programs from an old API to the new API. Or when the size of the program makes it impractical or time consuming to refactor it by hand. Now I would like to go to the next slide, that is phases of compiler, where you can see a diagram where the source program is getting translated to a target program, that is source code is getting into object code, which is the source program is passing through the lexical analyzer first, then syntax analyzer, then semantic analyzer, where all the analyzations of syntax or semantic grammar or errors are being checked, and then it is passing through the intermediate code generator, and then the code is being optimized, and again the code is getting generated, and we get the object code, that is the target program. In between, Symbol Table Manager manages all the analyzers and code generators and optimizer, and Error Handler handles all the errors being occurred in the program, and it also notifies whether there is a bug in the program or not. Now, I would like to go to the next slide of code generation and optimization, that is the main topic of our PowerPoint. Code generation can be considered as the final phase of compilation. Through post-code generation, optimization process can be applied on the code, but that can be seen as a part of code generation phase itself. The code generated by the compiler is an object code of some lower level programming language, for example, assembly language. Now, the question is, what is code optimization in compiler design? The code optimization in the synthesis phase is a program transformation technique which tries to improve the intermediate code by making it consume fewer resources, that is CPU memory, so that faster running machine code will result. Compiler optimizing process should meet the following objectives. The first one is, the optimization must be correct. It must not in any way change the meaning of the program. The second is, optimization should increase the speed and performance of the program too. The third one is, the compilation time must be kept reasonable. And the last one is, the optimization process should not delay the overall compiling process. Now, there arises two questions, when to optimize and why to optimize the program in code. First, when to optimize. Optimization of the code is often performed at the end of the development stage, since it reduces readability and adds code that is used to increase the performance. And now, why to optimize? Optimizing is an algorithm, is beyond the scope of the code optimization phase, so the program is optimized, and it may involve reducing the size of the code too. So optimization helps to reduce the space consumed and increases the speed of the compilation. It manually analyzes data sets and involves a lot of time, hence we make use of software like Tableau for data analysis. Similarly, manual performing the optimization is also tedious and is better than using a code optimizer. An optimized code often promotes reusability. Now, what are the types of code optimization which can be done? It is basically classified into two types. Number one is machine independent optimization, and the number two is machine dependent optimization. Machine independent optimization. This code optimization is phase attempts to improve the intermediate code to get a better target code as the output. The part of the intermediate code which is transformed here does not involve any CPU registers or absolute memory locations. Hence, it is getting clarified that we are not using any memory locations or any resources to use it. Number two is machine dependent optimization. Machine dependent optimization is done after the target code has been generated and when the code is transformed according to the target machine architecture. It involves CPU registers and may have absolute memory references too, rather than the relative references. Machine-dependent optimizers put efforts to take maximum advantage of the memory hierarchy, that is, maximum advantage of the resource utilization by the computer. Thank you. Now I would like to hand over the next slide to Adhira Shah for the questionnaire part to explain.
Thank you, Oshi. Now question and answer here. The first question is, some code optimizations are carried out on the intermediate code because first option is they enhance the portability of the compiler to other target processors. Next option, program analysis is more accurate on intermediate code than on machine code. Third option is the information from data flow analysis cannot otherwise be used for optimization. And last option is the information from the front end cannot otherwise be used for optimization. This question came up GATE CSC 2008. So correct option is option A. They enhance the portability of the compiler to other target processors because intermediate codes are machine independent codes. So intermediate code can be used for code optimization. Since a given source code can be converted to target machine code, that is why correct option is option A. Now the next question is, Which language necessarily need heap allocation in the runtime environment? First option is those that support recursion. Second option is those that use dynamic scoping. Third option is those that allow dynamic data structures. And last option is those that use global variables. And this question came up GATE CSE 2010. And correct option is option C, those that allow dynamic data structures, because heap allocation is needed for dynamic data structures like tree, linked list, etc. And we know that runtime environment means we deal with dynamic memory allocation, and heap is a dynamic data structures. So it is clear that those languages that allow dynamic data structure necessarily need heap allocation in the runtime environment. That is why correct option is option C. And third question is, and consider the following C code segment. Please look at this code. And the question is, which one of the following is false? First option is the code contains loop invariant computation. Option B, there is a scope of common sub expression elimination in this code. Option C, there is a scope of strength reduction in this code. And last option is, there is a scope of dated code elimination in this code. And this question came up GATE CSE 2006. And the correct option is option D, because look at this code, line number 7. 4 into j is a common sub expression elimination, so B is true. Now 5 into i can be moved out of inner loop, so can be I module 2, means A is true, as we have loop invariant computation. Now 4 into j as well as 5 into i can be replaced with a is equal to minus 4. Before j loop is j loop, then a is equal to a plus 4, where 4 into j is computed. Likewise for 5 into i, so c is true, as there is a scope of strength reduction by choice elimination. We have option D, so correct option is option D. So we are ending our session here. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. I'll give you a PPT and all.